Hi gang, we're gonna do some more review of operant conditioning. Remember, in operant conditioning, we're talking about reinforcements and punishments. Reinforcement, the goal is always to increase behavior. Punishment, the goal is always to decrease behavior. There are the two reinforcements, the application of something pleasant, which is a positive reinforcement, or the removal of something unpleasant, which is a negative reinforcement. Goal, always to increased behavior. The two punishments, we have positive punishment, which is the application of an unpleasant situation, and negative punishment, which is the removal of a pleasant situation. Understand that the positive and negative in operant conditioning is not in any way, shape, or form a judgment call. Positive means something is being applied. Negative means something is being removed. That's all it means. So some examples for some more practice. Okay, if parents allow their children to escape from unpleasant activities in order to increase the amount of household chores they complete, the parents are using. Okay, if you don't know what this is about, first thing we need to do, figure out reinforcement or punishment. And we can tell right here, increasing. If the behavior is going up, that means it has to be a reinforcement. So already we can cross out the punishment. So then the question is something being applied or is something being removed? And you can see right here, they're being allowed to escape. So escape would be a removal. So that would be a negative. So that would be the negative reinforcement. Now Max is usually late to class. His math and history teachers have been making him wash all the desks in their classrooms during study hall when he is late. Because he hates washing desks so much, Max has been late to class less frequently. How is he being conditioned? All right, so Max's behavior, we need to figure out going up or going down. And you can see right here, less frequently, it's going down. And since it's going down, that means it has to be a punishment. So we're going to cross out the reinforcements immediately. So how is his behavior being encouraged to go down? Is it positive? Is he getting something he doesn't like? Or is it negative? Is something being taken away? Because remember, positive is applied, negative is minus or removed. And here, he's being made to wash all the desks. So something is being given to him. Something has been added on. So since he's getting something added, that would be a positive punishment. Now, Janine has to hand in weekly reports every Friday. When she hands in completed reports before lunch, Janine's boss takes her to Dunkin' for coffee and a muffin. Janine has been turning in her completed reports before lunch more and more frequently. So according to operant conditioning, how is Janine being conditioned? Again, if you know what this is right off the bat, go for it. But if you're like, ugh, I don't know how to figure it out, what's happening to Janine's behavior? Is it going up or going down? And here is where we know what's going on with Janine. We know more frequently it's going up. If it's going up, that has to be a reinforcement. So say bye-bye to the punishments. So is her behavior increasing because she's being given something she likes, or is she having something she doesn't like taken away? Now, I don't know about y'all, but I'm with Janine in that coffee and a muffin is a good thing, and it's definitely something that's being given to her. So since it's something that's being applied or given to her, that has to be a positive. So this would be a positive reinforcement situation. Now, Coach T is annoyed that his athletes show up to practice out of uniform. He has implemented a new policy that anyone who shows up out of uniform is not allowed to attend the Carbon and movie night at his house. Coach T is happy that the number of athletes showing up out of uniform has decreased. According to operant conditioning, how is Coach T conditioning his athletes? So what's happening to the athlete's behavior? Decreased, which means it's going down. Automatically going down, that has to be a punishment. So we can say goodbye to the reinforcements. And now we're down to a 50-50 shot here. And what is the 50-50 shot? Is Coach giving them something in this situation? Or is he taking something away? And he can tell right here, not allowed. not allowed to attend. So something is not happening for them. Something is being taken away. So it's a minus. Something's being subtracted. And that would have to be the negative because something is going away. And if you're good and you feel confident with operant conditioning, you can stop right now. If you're still very confused as to the basics of operant conditioning, I have some more here we can do. So let's talk about if parents tell their children they will have to do a nasty chore, such as cleaning out the refrigerator, in order to get them to stop doing an obnoxious behavior. Skinner and operant conditioning would explain that the parents are using. Okay. So, again, the goal, what are we trying to do to the behavior here? Because that's what we need to figure out first. Is it a reinforcement or a punishment? And we're trying to get the behavior to stop, which means we're trying to get the behavior to decrease. And if we're trying to get the behavior to decrease, we are automatically going for a punishment. Now, the question is, are the children being asked to do something additional, or are the children having something they like taken away? And here, they will have to do a nasty chore. They have to do it. So something is being added here. So since it's being added, we know it has to be a positive punishment. And we have Max again in another situation who has been leaving his dirty dishes, not his dishes, his clothes all over the house. Since Max hates to clean up the dog poop in the yard, his mom told him he could get out of that chore if he put his clothes in the hamper every day. Max has been putting his clothes in the hamper more often. According to operant conditioning, how is Max being conditioned? So his behavior, the behavior in question, is the dirty clothes putting him in the hamper. And he has been doing it more often right there. So more often, that means it's an increase. If it's an increase, we know that has to be a reinforcement. So, how is he being reinforced by his mom? Is she giving him something when he puts his clothes in a hamper? Or is she taking something away that he doesn't like? And if you'll notice here, he can get out of. He could get out of. Get out of. That's being taken away. He could be taken out of that chore if he does that. So because he's getting out of something, we know this is a negative reinforcement. And we have Janine again. She wants to go to France with her school over spring break. Her parents told her that they will give her $10 towards the trip for every test and paper she brings home that has a grade of B or higher. Janine has been bringing home more and more B or better tests and papers. So according to operant conditioning, how is Janine being conditioned? And we're right here, more and more. That's an increase. So because it's an increase, we know it has to be a reinforcement. Now, is she getting something that she likes? Is she being given something? Or is she having something she doesn't like taken away? I'm guessing she's being given. Right here it says they will give her $10. Give her. That's an add. That's a plus. So we know that's the positive. Now we have Coach T again, who's annoyed because his athletes show up for practice out of uniform. He has a new rule that if anyone shows up out of uniform, they will not be allowed to use the sauna after practice, and they love the sauna. Coach T is happy to report a decrease in the number of athletes showing up for practice out of uniform. According to operant conditioning, how is Coach T conditioning his athletes? Okay. Behavior increasing or decreasing, and the good news is we have it right here. The behavior is going down. Since it's going down, we know that it has to be a punishment. The question is he giving them something or is he taking something away? And right here we know, not allowed. Not allowed. Something is being taken away. So because something is being taken away, we know it's negative punishment. And if you're good now, feel free to stop. If you're like, oh, this is still confusing, good news. I got one more set of problems here on operant conditioning. Remember, positive, negative have to do with the application or the removal of something. not a judgment call. So if parents tell their children they can escape from boring dinner table after they increase the number of bites of their vegetables, the parents are using, again, behavior, going up, going down, increasing, it's going up, we know it's going up. So that means it has to be a reinforcement. Are they getting something given to them? Or are they getting something taken away from them? And here's one of the words that gives it away. Escape. Escape. That's a takeaway, isn't it? You're getting away from something. So since it's an escape, that would be a negative reinforcement. Max, yet again, has been having trouble learning vocabulary from his Spanish class. His dad told Max for every 10 new words that he learns, he will give him a new stone for his rock polisher. Now Max learns a new word every week. According to Operant Conditioning, how is Max being conditioned? All right, so behavior increase or decreasing? He learns a new word every week. That's a good thing. That's an increasing thing, isn't it? So it's increasing, going up. So because it's going up, we know it's bye-bye punishments, it's only reinforcements. So how is this being reinforced? Is he being given something or having something taken away? And right there, look, that's one of the key words. He's being given a new stone. So because he's being given, that's an addition, that would be the positive reinforcement. Janine, yet again, often late to work. When she is late, her boss has her work in the back and not with customers. Janine does not like being away from the fun interactions, and her late days at work have decreased. According to Operant Conditioning, how is Janine being conditioned? Again, behavior, going up, going down, magic word, decreased, going down. Since it's going down, we know it has to be a punishment. But is she being given something or is something being taken away from her? You can tell she's not with customers. She doesn't like being away. She's being removed, right? And removed, if you're being removed, isn't that a minus? And if it's a minus, it means it has to be a negative. And Coach T, some more athletes, showing up for practice out of uniform. He has started a new policy that any athlete who shows up out of uniform has to do 10 minutes of wall squats, which they hate. Coach T is happy to report a decrease in the number of athletes showing up for practice out of uniform. Apparently, Coach T is really concerned about his athletes showing up in uniform. So according to Operant Conditioning, how is Coach T conditioning his athletes? And of course, the behavior, what's the goal of the behavior? What's he trying to do? He's trying to decrease something. So he's trying to decrease something, which means no reinforcement. It has to be a punishment. And the question is he giving them something? Is he applying something? Or is he taking something away? And you can see here a new policy they have to do. So something's being applied, something's being given. That would be a positive, an add-on. So he is doing a positive punishment to try and decrease the number of times out of uniform. So that's a quick review of operant conditioning. Remember, key things in operant conditioning. Reinforcements always increase behavior. Punishments always decrease behavior. Positive and negative, not judgments. Positive means something's being applied. Negative means something is being taken away. So, thank you. Bye-bye.